The Philippine men's basketball team suffers a painful loss against SEA Games host Cambodia. This led Manny Pangilinan, the Samahang Basketball ng Pilipinas Chairman Emeritus, to air his frustration on social media. He called it a disgraceful loss that will be etched deeply in infamy. Cambodia, which fielded only 7 players in the game, 6 of whom were naturalized, stunned Gilas with a 79-68 win on Thursday, giving the Philippines its first defeat in the group stage since 1997.
Filipino athletes continue to harvest medals in the Southeast Asian Games in Cambodia, but Team Philippines is struggling to climb up in the rankings. Eric Cray delivered the country's lone gold on Thursday, winning a 6th straight 400-meter hurdles event. This brings the country's gold medal haul to 27. But while other Filipino athletes also scored podium finishes on Thursday, Team Philippines remains in 6th place, the overall medal tally. The country is hoping for more golds heading into the final few days of the biennial competition, thanks to 9 boxers who are in the finals of their respective divisions. Twitter CEO Elon Musk says he has found his successor for the social media platform. In a tweet, Musk, who did not give a name, said he will transition to being an executive chair and CTO to oversee product, software, and system operations. The move is said to allay the growing concerns of Tesla investors on the time that Musk is devoting to turning around Twitter.
Business news overseas now. U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen again issuing a stark warning over the looming threat of a U.S. debt default. In a press conference ahead of the G7 meeting in Japan, Yellen said a default from the failure to raise America's $31.4 trillion debt limit could trigger a global economic downturn. Yellen also echoed U.S. President Joe Biden's words that the threat of default is just a manufactured crisis by Republicans.
A default would threaten the gains that we've worked so hard to make over the past few years in our pandemic recovery, and it would spark a global downturn that would set us back much further. Short of a default, brinksmanship over the debt limit can also impose serious economic costs. We know this from recent history. As we learned in 2011, just the serious threat of default can lead to a downgrade of our credit rating and a weakening of consumer confidence. We could see a rise in interest rates, drive up payments on mortgages, auto loans, and credit cards.
The Biden administration and Republican leaders are at odds over a Republican-backed House bill that calls for deep spending cuts in exchange for raising the debt ceiling. Yellen has warned the U.S. could run out of cash to pay its bills as early as June 1st if the limit isn't increased.
The Philippine economy grows at a slower pace in the first quarter of the year. The economy expanded 6.4%, the slowest in 7 quarters, but it came in better than the 6.1% estimate of analysts. Construction, manufacturing, and financial and insurance activities were the main drivers of growth in the first 3 months of 2023. For NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan, the Philippine economy is normalizing rather than slowing down and is on track to meet this year's 6-7% growth target.
We need to exercise caution in interpreting this as a slowdown, since the previous year's growth came from a low base. Rather, the economy is normalizing its previous trend. The better-than-expected first quarter performance this year implies that we are returning to our high growth trajectory despite the various challenges and the headwinds we have faced. However, we have much more work to realize our social and economic transformation agenda toward a prosperous, inclusive, and resilient Philippines.